the sum of the first two terms of a geometric progression, which is GP, is X, and the sum of the last two terms is Y. If there are n terms in all, we are now required to find the common ratio. First, suppose we are given some terms that form what? A GP. Meaning, we have first term. Are you with me? We have the second term, okay? We have the third term, okay? Dot, dot, dot. We have our Tn minus 1. And we have our what now? Our Tn. How do I get Tn minus 1? And how do you get what now? Tn. Class, look at this. This is the first term. This is the second term, okay? This is the third term. How did you get T2? It means 3 minus 1 will give us what now? 2. Are you with me? How did we get the first term? It means what now? 2 minus 1 will give us what now? 1. Are you with me? Suppose this T3 is now Tn. Are you with me, class? So it means the term that we see before this T3 will give us what now? Tn minus 1. Do you understand? So meaning, if this our n, our 3 is what? Is n. How are we going to get these 2? It will be what now? 3 minus 1. So if that 3 is now what now? N. How are we going to get our what now? D2. That would be what now? N minus 1. This is how I got what now? Tn, which is the last term. And this is Tn minus 1, which is the term that we're going to see before the last term. Are you with me? So here, let's say the sum of the first two terms of that GP is what? Is X. So I take this and I take this. So I have what now? T1 plus T2 equals what now? Equals to X. What is now the general formula? Okay, under the GP, the n term of a GP, we have Tn, okay, equals to what? Ar raised to the power what now? N minus 1. So for the first step, we'll be having T1, okay, equals to what now? A raised to the power what now? 1 minus what? 1. So we have what? Ar raised to the power what now? 0. R raised to the power 0 will give us 1. So which implies we're having what now? A times 1 here, we have our A. So the formula for the first step, okay, will give us what now? A. Then plus, what will be the formula for the second term? Let's go, class. Are you with me? So in this case, our n will be equal to what now? 2. So second term, T2 equals to what now? A, R raised to the power what now? 2 minus 1. So we'll now be having what now? AR raised to the power what now? 1, which is what now? AR. So the formula for the second term is AR. So we are saying A plus AR equals to what now? X. Class. Are you with me? So we can make A, bring A out here. A is common to both sides, so I can bring A out. If I should bring A out, I'll have what? A, open bracket, we'll leave it what here? 1. So we have 1 plus, we'll leave it what here? R equals what now? X. Class, are you with me? So here we have A times 1, A times R, AR. So let's continue. Then I said what now? And the sum of the last two terms, meaning this is the last term, this is the term I'm going to see before the last what now? Before the last term. So I'm adding this and this. They must give me what now? Why? So it means we're adding what now? Let us this is equation what? Equation 1. So we have Tn, are you with me? Minus 1 plus Tn equals what now? Y. So this is the last two terms. Okay? This is the sum of the last two terms. So what is the n term? This n term, the formula is what now? A average power n minus 1. So I can quickly write what now? A r raised to power n minus 1 for this equals to what now? Y. So what is our Tn minus 1? So how do you get that? Look at this class. We said our Tn equals what? A r raised to power what now? N minus 1. If I now have Tn minus 1, which implies this n here has changed to what now? N minus 1. So anywhere I see n, I will put what now? N minus 1. Are you with me? So this will now become A r, this n now change to what now? N minus 1, then I have what? Minus 1 here. Are you with me, class? Meaning, this n, anywhere I see n, it will change to what now? N minus 1. So this is n here. This n will change to what now? N minus 1. Are you with me? So now we have been a r raised to the power what now? N minus 1 minus 1 gives us what now? Minus 2. So which implies the formula for this is a r, okay, raised to the power what now? N minus what now? Minus 2. Look at this. Now, okay, look at this equation and this equation. 1 plus r is here. Can I find 1 plus r here too? I mean, can I get 1 plus r in this relation that combines this and this together? Let's see. If I should put 1 plus r here, if I open the bracket And I put 1 plus R here. Are you with me? Which implies I'm adding what here? AR raised to the power M minus 1 as a factor. If I bring this one out, AR raised to the power M minus 1 times 1 will give us this. Are you with me? Then AR raised to the power M minus 1 times R. Let us see what will happen here. Meaning, let's see whether we're going to have what now? AR raised to the power M minus 1. Meaning, I have AR raised to the power M minus 2. Okay. Times what now? Times R. What is going to give us? Now we have been A. You know, this one is what? Times R raised to the power what? N. Okay. Then times R raised to the power what now? Minus 2 from indices. Then times R raised to the power what now? 1. Are you with me? This is R raised to the power N. Times R raised to the power what now? Minus 2 from indices. Meaning if I combine this one and this one, I will take one out and I will now add N minus 2. Are you with me to get this? So from here, we now be having A times, I will combine all this R. We have what? R raised to the power what now? M minus 2 plus 1. So minus 2 plus 1 gives us what now? Minus 1. So this one will now come A R raised to the power what now? M minus 1 minus 1, which is very correct. So here, if I say A R raised to the power M minus 2 times 1, I will have this. Okay? Then A R raised to the power M minus 2 times R, I will have this. So we'll be able to factorize what? We'll be able to what? Bring this one out. We brought A R raised to the power what now? M minus 1 because it is common in what now? In both sides. Are you with me? I can bring A R raised to the power M minus 2. I can get it in this one, meaning I'll be left with what now? With R. Look at this equation. We have 1 plus R here. We also have 1 plus R here. Let's make 1 plus R the subject of formula here and we equate it to what now? Equations. Are you with me? So from here, what are we having in class? Are you with me in class? So we have this from equation 1, this is equation 2. So let's say from what? From equation what? Equation 1. Equation 1. Okay. Let's make 1 plus R the subject of formula. Our 1 plus R will be equal to, this one will come down here. We have what? X over what now? X over A. Let's now go to equation 2. From equation 2, plus I hope you are with me. Okay, so let's continue. From equation 2, let us make 1 plus R sub formula 2. So from equation 2, 1 plus R, 1 plus R will be equal to what now? This one will come down here. So we have Y all over what? A R raised to power N minus what now? N minus 2. So this one, equation 3. This one, equation what now? 4. I cannot equate these two equations because they are the same. 1 plus R. 1 plus R. 1 plus R is what now? S over A. Another 1 plus R. That same 1 plus R equals what now? Y all over A R raised to power N minus 2. So I can equate this one and this. We now be having equating what now? Equations 3 and 4. We now have what? X all over A equals what now? Y all over A R raised to power N minus what? Minus 2. So what happened? So I can come here. Let this one can come here. So now we have been A R, okay, raised to power what? N minus 2 all over what? A equals, this one will come down here. Y all over what now? X. Do you understand what I did here? This one went up here. This one come down. Just by saying what now? We are cross multiplying. So I went up. This one comes down. So what's next thing? This A will cancel this A. We're looking for R. So R raised to the power what now? M minus 2 equals to what now? Y all over what now? Y over X. That if I want to remove this sign, okay, I have to multiply this power by its what now? Reciprocal. Meaning if I have R raised to the power M minus 2 times 1 all over, okay, M minus 2. Okay, look at this. Look at what I'm doing here. This is this. Meaning I'm multiplying this power by its reciprocal. Everything will cancel out. Are you with me? Once I do something like this here, I must do it to the other side. So I will have been y all over x, everything is power what now? 1 all over m minus what now? Minus 2. So this one will cancel out this. Our r will now be equal to what now? Y all over x, everything is power what now? 1 all over m minus what now? Minus 2. So which implies the common ratio to that question is y all over x, everything is power 1 all over n minus 2. Plus, if you've enjoyed the solution to this video, okay, now I want you to do me something. Just subscribe to my YouTube channel. Just click the subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up, share the video, and again, most importantly, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Just click the subscribe button below this video. Thank you very much for watching. Bye bye.